Class 11, Subject Education, Chapter 2, Aims of Education, Individual and Social Aims. In my previous video, I had already discussed about the individual and social aims. Today, I am going to study about arguments in favor of individual aim, argument in disfavor of individual aim, argument in favor of social aim, and arguments in disfavor of social aim. In arguments in favor of individual aim, their total focus is on in favor of individual aim. They are in full support of individual aim. See, their focus is on individuality. This aim believes in the indefinite value of the individual person. Their emphasis should be given to the individual. Their emphasis is on the individual's personality development. Their focus is not on society or people, but their focus is on only individual, a person, on his abilities, his learning experiences, his goal, his opportunities, his personality, his values. So this aim is in favor of self, okay, is in favor of individuality. In favor of individual. So there are some arguments in disfavor of individual aim. There are some people who are against of this. According to them, because this is somewhere is totally depends on self, or you can say that focuses on self. So according to them, the self-expression leads to feeling of self-assertion, which develops egoistic behavior and selfish attitude in the individual. Okay. According to them, man is a social animal. It shows that beyond the society, the individual cannot survive in vacuum. According to them, man is a social animal. And without society, he cannot survive. According to them, when we give extra emphasis to develop the individuality in child, it creates problem. According to them, it culminates into the lopsided development of the child, which means one-sided. The emphasis on individual differences has lost the utility of social qualities of the children. According to them, they lost the availability of social qualities of the children because of the lopsided development. It encourages autocracy in the form of individuality. Autocracy, which means when power is in hand of one person. The highest aim of education, self-realization, cannot be fulfilled on the basis of development of more individuality. The social aim of education for this aim must be considered. Individual aim of education has its practical limitations because the personality of the individual is the function of heredity and environment. Individual aim of education has its practical limitations. Means according to them, they wanted to set them, individual aim has its practical limitations. There is a limit, there is a barrier. Okay. Now let's have a look on the favorable points of social aim. So there are some points in favor of social aim and some in unfavor. So in favorable points, they are in full support of socialism. According to them, man is a social individual and fulfill all his desired from the society. He has deep roots in society. Therefore, education must be in order to prepare him a sociable and good citizen. According to them, they wanted a man to be a sociable person. Society nourishes civilization and culture. The man possesses innate instincts which are molded according to social values and ideals. Thus, education work for social development of the individual. According to them, education work for social development of the individual. And according to them, social development is very important. And this is possible through education. Men's nature is social as truly as it is self-regarding, and self-realization or development of personality can be achieved only through a social environment. Development of personality can be achieved only through a social environment. See, their total focus, or they emphasized social development a lot. And according to them, a man should be a social person. He should be sociable. And when he is social, his whole development, his personality development is possible. His physical, intellectual, spiritual, all developments are possible. So they are total in favor of socialism. But there are some points which is unfavorable. Let's have a look on some unfavorable points of social aim of education. Points which are not in a favor of social aim of education, which are against of social aim. See, individual as non-entity is the first and foremost criticism against the social aim of education. All the powers are invested in a state. Because when you are so much social able or social person, the power is not in your hand. The power is in the hand of state. So you are not capable to do so many things. Okay. It involves an absence of creativeness. There is so much absence of what? Creativeness. Because you are a social person, you don't have so much rights. Okay. So you are not allowed to do so many things. It developed narrow-mindedness in relation to country, religion and society. It develops blunt thinking and unscientific understanding. Most importantly, what it develops? Narrow-mindedness. It represses the individual freedom of expression, means it stops the individual freedom of expression. Because you are a social person, so you are related with some people, some organization, some society, so you are not allowed and you are not free to do things. So there is, you can say that absence of freedom. It promotes loop-sided development in individuals as it puts more emphasis on social and political development. It is very, very simple to understand that it puts more emphasis, more focus on social and political development. So it reduces what? Your mental, your spiritual, your moral development. Okay? So these all are the important favorable and unfavorable points of individual and social aim of education. Favorable aims are in favor and unfavorable aims are not in favor of these educations. I hope you can understand all this. That's all for today. Thank you so much.